A head-on collision has 5 people in the hospital tonight. This happened at the corner of Bonita Beach Road and Bonita Grand. Witnesses say the driver of that white car was trying to make a U-turn. It collided head-on into that oncoming blue car. First responders had to pull 4 people from the car. Someone had to be airlifted to the hospital in critical condition. We talked to family friends on scene. They immediately rushed to help.
You know, well, that's where I worry about my niece right now, you know, because she's my, you know, she's like my daughter, you know.
The family tells us at least one of the people in critical condition is a child.
The cause of a deadly boating accident that took the life of a 12-year-old boy is still under investigation. The boy died after the boat that he was in crashed into the base of the Midpoint Bridge on Saturday. NBC2's Gabrielle Shirley has the latest.
A deadly accident on the water on Saturday morning.
Get in here to see what was really going on. Everything was roped off.
The scene remained for hours, causing the people who frequent the area surrounding the Midpoint Bridge to worry.
Something tragic, you know, somebody got killed, serious accident, something like that.
Sadly, this man was right. 12-year-old Noah Pollock and his brother, 10-year-old Wade, were both thrown into the water after the boat hit the base of the bridge. They were with their grandfather and their father.
It's sad and tragic.
Noah died on the scene. His brother was transported to Tampa General Hospital. He was listed in critical condition when we checked with the hospital yesterday.
Condolences to their family. I can't imagine it. I have a 3-year-old son, so.
We did ask the investigating agency, FWC, directly if the boat malfunctioned before it crashed into the base of the bridge. They tell us they have not determined the exact cause. We also asked them if alcohol played a role in the crash. They say they're not sure yet.
I can't imagine what the mom and the dad's going through and the granddad. I'm sure they're not going to go in the water too much lately. And now this weekend's going to, you know, family's supposed to be together, and now it's going to cause them to remember that all the time. That's horrible.
We do know the grandfather who was driving the boat was listed in fair condition at last check. Reporting in Lee County, Gabrielle Shirley, NBC2.
Crews in St. Lucie County came to the rescue this weekend after a boat capsized off North Hutchinson Island. 4 adults were on that boat Sunday morning. All of them are okay.
It has been a year since Diana Alvarez went missing from her home in San Carlos Park.
She was only 9 years old at the time of her disappearance, but her family is not giving up hope. A search team will continue to look for her tomorrow.
NBC2's Megan Bragg spoke with Diana's mother as they prepare for a vigil tonight.
And that vigil will take place here tonight, a year later, and this memorial still stands with no sign of Diana.
Today marks a year that we don't know anything about her. It's not easy. It's hard.
A year later and still no sign of Diana Alvarez after she disappeared from her home in San Carlos Parkway.
To have to wonder where your child is or if they're safe or not.
Many people remember the day she went missing as countless searches around several counties came up short.
You just felt the, you know, the creepiness in the air. I mean, it was really upsetting.
And a lot has happened since that day. Diana turned 10, and this man, George Guerrero, is in jail after he was found guilty for storing inappropriate pictures of Diana on his cell phone. He's the only person of interest in her disappearance, but never charged. But Tuesday is a new day with new hopes as a team from Peace River Canine Search and Rescue start to look for Diana.
A lot of people are going to come look for her again. We're hoping they find something new in what they do.
Family, friends, and neighbors are expected to come out here at around 7 to begin that prayer for Diana. Reporting live in San Carlos Park, Megan Bragg, NBC2.
Tomorrow, a volunteer group will start their new search. They're going to start at Diana's home in South Lee County. That's the last place she was seen. And they're going to search all the way up to Yeehaw Junction, hours away in Central Florida. Jorge Guerrero is the main suspect in Diana's disappearance. He was recently convicted of child pornography because he had naked pictures of Diana on his cell phone. He used to live at their home in San Carlos Park. Investigators think he took Diana, but again, they don't have enough evidence to prove it.
NBC2 News alert. The Collier County Sheriff's Department is looking for 2 women who went missing hours after they graduated from college. 20-year-olds Raina Verdick and Elsa Angelo were last seen around 11 p.m. Friday at Miller's Ale House at Gulf Coast Town Center in Lee County. Just hours before, they both graduated from Florida Gulf Coast University. Deputies say they may be in the Miami area. If you see them, call the Collier County Sheriff's Office.
Lee County firefighters are reminding everyone a burn ban is still in place. That means fireworks and other burning is strictly off limits. The rain we've seen in recent weeks is not enough to stop the wildfire risk. That means no burning outside, with the exception of a grill. There has been a growing trend of people lighting off fireworks on Memorial Day. Firefighters say that puts them on high alert. The smallest spark could do major damage.
It's really important that we practice fire safety. And again, it's not just the woods that are catching on fire, but we have homes that burn, cars, campers, a lot of stuff that usually isn't end up being on the homeowner's property, but the adjacent property where the fireworks land.
The 7-day countywide burn ban ends tomorrow, but firefighters are convinced there will be another week extension because of the dry conditions.
Officials say traffickers are bringing more cocaine to South Florida than at any time in the past decade. Well, take a look at this. This video of $56 million worth of cocaine that was offloaded in St. Petersburg earlier this month. The Coast Guard confiscated it from multiple drug smugglers. 90% of the cocaine seized in the United States can be traced back to Colombia.
The FBI is concerned about an uptick in biker gang activity in South Florida. It says the Outlaw Motorcycles Club is trying to establish dominance over other clubs, particularly in the Florida Keys. The agency warns that gang fights at motorcycle rallies could be expected.
An NBC2 traffic alert: a construction project will close a lane on Cape Coral Parkway near Skyline Boulevard. Crews will be working on a broken sewer main and will need to close down one lane of traffic, so it could be slow going. Avoid the area if you can.
A Southwest Florida veteran dies just weeks before being honored for his service. Coming up, how his loved ones are remembering him today.
He died November. They put these up like a month ago, Jerry said.
Well, they're saying he died like a few weeks ago before the ban.
Oh.
I knew that.
Yep, check. I can hear ya. Reese's mic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Mic check. Reese's mic.